This is problem number 12 from chapter 5. We're talking about forces. So we have two horizontal forces, F1 and F2, act on a 4-kilogram disc that slides over frictionless ice on which an XY coordinate system is laid out. Force F1 is in the positive direction on the X-axis and has a magnitude of 7 newtons. Force F2 has a magnitude of 9 newtons. The figure gives the X component, coordinates, just the X component, Vx of the velocity of the disc as a function of time t during the sliding. What is the angle between the constant directions of forces F1 and F2? So first I want to address something that some people get confused about. It says two horizontal forces. Sometimes some students think that means that they're automatically already in the X direction. But that's not what it means at all. It just means that it's on a horizontal surface, and so gravity is not affecting it. It's just like on a table, for example, with a XY coordinate system drawn on it. So I like to write out what I know. So I know that the mass is 4 kilograms of this disc. And then F1 is 7 newtons just in the X direction, and F2 is 9, and that's the one that we don't know. And so F1, I could sketch right here. F2 is maybe going this way, maybe going that way. We don't really know, but we're trying to find this angle right there. And so what I would want to do, because this feels a little bit daunting at first because you don't know exactly how to proceed, is I would look at my graph. And I know that I have a graph of velocity versus time. And we know that the slope of this graph or the derivative of this graph would be our acceleration. And so that's where I want to start because I know that force and acceleration are tightly linked. And so this is up at 5 in the y, on the y-axis, and this is at -4. And so to get the slope, I'll just do change in y over change in x. So I'll have 5 minus -4 over, and then in the x is 3 minus 0. So I'll have 9 over 3 equals 3 meters per second squared. And remember, this is not the entirety of my acceleration. This is just the acceleration in the x direction because that's the velocity in the x direction. And so since forces and accelerations are vector quantities, we can use this to figure out the entire force in the x direction. So I would write force in the x direction equals mass times acceleration in the x direction. And of course, mass is a scalar quantity, so that can be used in whatever direction we please. So force in the x is going to be 4 times 3, which equals 12 newtons. That's my total force in the x direction from force 1 and force 2. And we know that force 1 equals 7 newtons completely in the x direction. So this is an axis. Let's sketch that. What that tells us, we know that our total force in the x direction is 12 newtons. And so if that's the case, then that means that force 2 just in the x direction alone would have to be 12 minus 7, which equals 5 newtons. But we know that's not the whole force. We know that the entire force is 9 newtons. And so that must be going up at an angle like this or down at an angle like this. And so I'll draw it right here because this angle here and this angle down here are going to be the same. Just one is positive and one is negative. And so either could be a good answer. So if I have 5 newtons for force 2 in the x direction, you know, let me draw this over here. So here's force 2 in the x direction that equals 5. I know that my force 2 in total equals 9. I could solve for my force 2 in the y direction, but I actually don't need to because all I really want to know is what is this angle theta between this x direction force of F1 and then this direction of the force F2. And so fortunately, we already have a right triangle drawn here. So I know that cosine theta will equal 5 over 9, and then I can use my calculator to solve for theta, and that will equal 56.3 degrees. And that is indeed the angle between F1 in the x direction and F2 going off at this angle. And the answer could also be -56.3 degrees, because as we discussed, our F2 could be going down like that. And we solved it.